Hello my friends, and welcome back to my channel. As I said in the last recording, I was going to do embroidery on my cover. So I used a light blue-gray color and made some stitches and French knots on it like this. So I think I'm going to leave it for now, and we are going to do something totally different today. I was looking for something for my watercolors, some brushes I knew I had somewhere, and then I found all these tea bags that I have coffee dyed and made patterns on some of them. And I got this idea that I could maybe do something more with them. So I'm going to use these that are just coffee dyed but not patterned. And we are going to see if we can do something fun with them and use them as decorations in the journals later on. So I have also picked out a few old book pages and some pieces from napkins. So I thought we could do decoupage and then put it on to textile and use it as beautiful decorations. So I'm not sure how this works, but let's try it out together if my idea can work. So let's take a couple of these tea bags and then we are going to take them apart so that we can use both sides. That was easy. Let's do at least four, so we have a few to choose from. Then of course you can kind of do like this and rip them if you think that it's too straight and too, but you can do that afterwards also if you would like to. So let's start with putting something beautiful on to these tea bags and then put the tea bags on something else. Layers and layers, you know. So I have these pieces from a napkin, so let's use this. See how much we need to take it off. Somewhere there, I think. That can work. And then I'm just going to use one layer, so the thinnest layer with the pattern on. And then we are just going to take some decoupage glue and glue this onto the tea bag. So let's move on to the next step. I realized that these book pages that I have picked out was too small. I want the text to be seen on the side of the tea bag. So let's go with some bigger ones. It's still this nice Gothic style on the papers. A friend of mine reached out to me today and asked if I still wanted some old books. She had bought something from me that she was going to pick up, and then she would take some of the books with her. And I thought, yes, she have 2 or 3 books maybe that I could have. It was from an old school, and she had saved these. And it turned out that it was a full big box. So now I have kind of many old books. It was from the 1920, 1930, 1940, kind of that. So there wasn't any Gothic style on them, but there were a lot of beautiful covers that I can use. So that's good enough. They are dried, and now I'm thinking that we are going to put it on some textile so we can sew on it and do something other fun. So I have this blue one and these white ones. So let's do both. Do some different sizes. We can change the size on the textile later when we have decided where to use them and how to use them. A little bit smaller. Thank you. I'm not gluing it too hard. I'm going to sew around them on my sewing machine and maybe do some embroidery too. So I'm pleased if they are so that they stay in place. This was the one that I glued on top with my ordinary glue. And you can see that it got a bit more shiny than the other ones. The decoupage glue is matte and this is shiny, so we might need to put a layer of decoupage glue on top of that. I'm not sure about the shininess. Really like the feeling this gives with all the layers. It's almost like big snippet clusters. Putting a little bit more glue so it stays in place. have our papers on to the textile pieces. And now we are going to layer on some more decorations before we sew them. So I think we will start with some cheesecloth and some more textile pieces. So let's go with some colored cheesecloth on this one. That was a bit boring. Start with that. See where it takes us. Two. I like that white edge, so I'm leaving that to be seen. Was a bit too kind of hard. We need something with a bit more color on. To get the tool for ripping up textile and make it a bit more fun. My husband have given me a new, or my fiance have given me a new name, Destroyer. He thinks I'm crazy when I'm doing my decorations. Always destroying things to make them look old. We are a bit crazy in the journaling world. I have got the name Crazy Swedish Lady, so I guess he has right when he says I'm a bit crazy at destroying things. No, we need something lighter on this one. See if we can rip this too. A bit. I was going to say the last one, but it wasn't the last one. Do it a bit different and put it in the corner. lace. Kind of in the ripping mood today. Tear this down a bit, it's too big. Another layer on this one. Something more on this. put it that way. And maybe a little piece in the corner to hang down. To keep it together, kind of. Like that. So a couple of more details before we decide if these are done. We need some more of these labels, I think. This will probably need something more up here as the flower or decoration didn't seem so well. So, but we save that for later when we know where we're going to use it. Maybe not right on top of the flower. Dressing it a little bit extra.
piece of the old wallpaper from my farm. Did go well with that green. Okay, I think they are done. Like that, with some small embroidery piece of some nice colored thread will be the perfect thing when I know where I will put them. We can decorate them a little bit more. But these are nice base to starters with, and I love the outcome with the all the layers. I love layers. So thank you so much for keeping me company. I hope I could inspire you at least a little bit, so you can do some fun things to play with. Thank you so much for watching, and see you soon again. Until next time, bye bye from Sweden.